impact of globalization are the contemporary issues of engineering and technology from the very fact that the papers that we have received in this conference. So, my dear delegates and students, you should all strive to understand what is happening and what is that we can do to the society. So the our efforts and the all the emphasis, all the things that we do, whether education, engineering, research, everything, so that should have a direct impact on the social structure of our country or rather our in the world. So unless we do something to the society with our research and with our education, that's of no use. Even you can also understand, some of you might be aware, while you know we apply for funding, research funding to funding agencies like DST and AICT and other UGC organizations for research funding, there is a column, what is the social impact of this project. So if you can write a proposal which is having a high social impact, then your proposal is having like the likelihood of getting 100% funding. So we should always think in these lines, that the how any research or education is going to affect the very life of a common man on the face of the earth, and how it is going to help, how it is going to minimize the hardships that are being faced by the rural folks, so downtrodden people and backward, living in the most backward areas. So if you think in these lines, so the latest buzzword, all of you know that IoT, Internet of Things, has almost on the verge of revolutionizing the very life of everybody. So this kind of technology, this kind of knowledge should be utilized properly for the betterment of the common man's life on the earth. So with these few words, it's a ocean-like thing. If you we can speak for volumes and volumes and for days and days on such themes like contemporary engineering and technology. So that's what is happening. So you know, every area, every domain is getting the world is changing. The world is changing so fast that we are unable to catch up with the speed of the change. And mind you, this change, this speed with which the world is changing, the technology is changing, is creating opportunities. Opportunities for employment, opportunities for research, opportunities for introducing newer and newer courses in the academic fields. Now, opportunities for services sector and opportunities for every sector. This change is giving so many, it's creating so many opportunities, and also this change is coupled to the globalization and internationalization, which has almost erased the barriers between even the countries also, because you need not physically relocate yourself to do something alone, to give some service to a person who is living, person or corporate who is living in the other side of the globe, maybe Finland, because outsourcing has become and the become the world of the day, and you have the medium, communication medium, fastest communication medium to upload your findings and offer your services for this medium. So I really, being a person from having done my PhD engineering in early 70s, I really, sometimes I really wonder. So when I did my engineering in those days, I have used even vacuum tubes also. We used to conduct our experiments on vacuum tubes. So I have, not even the LSI was there. So now it is LSI, VLSI. Now next, what ULSI is also coming. So I have used the computer, IBM mainframe computer, IBM 1130 in our Andhra University, which used to be the CPU and all other things used to occupy a hall of this size. And the memory was very limited, I think it's in only MB. So having seen this change from those days to this days, right, I'm afraid what is going to happen in the future. You are all there, the future is yours, the youngsters. You will have a very good and grand environment for those people who want to really grab the opportunities. So it is, they are there. The thing is that you have to put in your effort. Unless you understand the things and identify the things, and then only you can ask, you can approve some, you can do something. So for that, you have to be almost always on your toes for understanding what is happening, to get awareness about the technologies that are happening. So this today's success mantra is very simple. In earlier days, we need to develop a very great depth in the subject if you want to flourish in your career. Today, it's not like that. Somebody is digging the well, and you need to draw the water using your bucket or something like that. No, if you want to utilize your energies to draw the water, you need not dig a well to have water. That is how. So if you develop breadth on the subject, you can understand, you can identify, and you can also suggest some solutions to the problems. So problem identification is also not that easy. So you should have a clear understanding, and you can also, you can see how people have become popular. So this is a problem understanding, and working towards a solution is a very the first step of any research. So, my dear delegates and students, I once again thank the all the heads of departments, staff members, for arranging this. International seminar, and I congratulate the delegates for coming forward to present their findings, and I request you all to participate wholeheartedly in this deliberations. And now, if you one question only, then something will come out. Okay, if you don't question, if you don't involve yourself in others' findings, Then it's not going to have for serve its purpose. See, even somebody who is presenting his work may not be aware of the shortcomings in his work, unless he questioning, such that he will have an opportunity to correct and to modify, to enhance his work. So I request you all to participate wholeheartedly, involve yourself in the research works, and enjoy the your presence here. And I from the bottom of my heart, I thank our management for encouraging us to go ahead with the conducting this seminar, that is the international seminar. Thank you. I wish you all a grand day. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for enlightening the audience with the impact of research on the society. And as said by our principal, today's students are very fortunate because for being born in the age of internet, where ocean of opportunities welcome you. So now let me invite our secretary, Sri Sira Radhakrishnamurthy garu, to convey his vision. Sir, please share.
ఇంటర్నేషనల్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్ అనేది ఫస్ట్ టైం ఇక్కడ మన స్టూడెంట్స్ కానీ మన లెక్చరర్స్ కానీ ఒకసారి వాళ్ళు చెప్పే అన్ని కూడా ఇంపార్టెంట్వి కూడా మనం తీసుకొని చక్కగా మనం అవలంబిస్తే బాగుంటుందని చెప్పేసి వారిని మన కాలేజీకి ఫస్ట్ టైం అన్నమాట మనం పిలిపించాము. వారు మన రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇచ్చేసి వారు వచ్చారు. తగిన ప్రోగ్రాం అంతా కూడా మన రమాదేవి గారు చూస్తారు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ యువర్ విషెస్. అండ్ నౌ లెట్ మీ వెల్కమ్ అవర్ ప్రెజర్ గారు, శ్రీ కొత్తమా శంకర్ గారు ఆన్ టు ది స్టేజ్. యా అడ్రస్ గారు
ప్లీజ్. రెస్పెక్టెడ్ అవర్ కాలేజ్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ డాక్టర్ కేనా సార్, అవర్ సెకండ్ ఇన్ కాస్ఫర్ రాధాక్ష గారు, our college mentor and my friend Tata Subbarao, Prabhakar sir, and today's chief guest Mr. Raghunath sir from NDRL, and my faculty members, HODs, students, very good morning. First of all, let us say thanks to all the department HODs. Interest conference first time mana premises lo mana college lo organized andariki kuda maa management tarapuna dhanyavaadalu. సో ఇలానే ఎన్నో కార్యక్రమాలు చేసుకోవాలి సార్. రఘునా సార్, దిస్ ఇస్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఎస్కేపీ యూనివర్సిటీలోని 1906 సాగేనండి. అంటే ఇవాళ 110 సంవత్సరాలు పూర్తి చేసుకొని 111 సంవత్సరాలు పెడుతున్నాం. దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఓన్లీ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఇన్ ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఐటి. మీ పక్కన సెక్రటరీ గారు గత 55 సంవత్సరాలు కూడా సొసైటీలో సర్వీస్ చేస్తారండి. దిస్ ఇస్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్. మా కమిటీ తరఫున కేజీ టు పీజీ అండ్ ప్రొఫెషనల్ కోర్స్ కూడా సుమారుగా 6,200 స్టూడెంట్స్ ఉన్నారు ఇక్కడ. మీ అందరూ ఆల్ ద కమిటీ మెంబర్స్, జస్ట్ వీఆర్ డూయింగ్ ద సర్వీస్, నాట్ కమర్షియల్, వీఆర్ 100% డూయింగ్ సర్వీస్ టు ఆల్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్. దిస్ ఈజ్ అబౌట్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్. సో అలానే మేము కూడా ఫ్యాకల్టీ కానీ చూసి కూడా చెప్పేదంటే మన కాలేజ్ కోసం ఏమైనా మేము చేయడానికి ఇంకా పాటు మేము రెడీగా ఉండాలి. మరొకసారి మీ అందరికీ చెప్పుకుంటూ నాకు ఈ అవకాశం ప్రిన్సిపల్కి థ్యాంక్స్ చెప్తూ సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
థ్యాంక్ యూ ప్రెజర్ గారు ఫర్ ఎన్లైటనింగ్ ద ఆడియన్స్ విత్ ద వెరీ ప్రెస్టీజియస్ హిస్టరీ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ ఎస్కేపీ సొసైటీ. అండ్ నౌ లెట్ మీ వెల్కమ్ ఆర్ మెంటర్ శ్రీ దత్త సుబ్బారావు గారు టు అడ్రస్ ద గ్యాదరింగ్ ప్లీజ్.
Dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, faculty and delegates. Very good morning. I believe if I am right, my HODs have told me that this is the third conference happening in this city, and we are fortunate to host that. And also we thank OSIET Prabhakar sir for associating with us, and also the today's chief guest. You know, it took some time, and then yesterday we met Raghunath garu, all the way coming from Tirupati. I think you got the picture of our society from our KV treasurer. It's 105 years old and all. And we are here to voluntarily support the education, particularly to the poor and needy community. That's where from 100 years onwards we are doing the same thing. And coming to the research and why we wanted to encourage as a part of the engineering is, recently Modi government, the central government, is focusing on the Make in India. And as a part of this, when he consulted some of his advisors, basically the advisors are IAS or the big business guys, they clearly explained, if you make a product and you earn 1 rupee on that, you know who will get 90 paisa of it? Who owns the technology? Examples are, you know, the Apple, Microsoft, Intel, Cisco. Do you know why Singapore, such a small country, is grown probably a lot faster than us, and also maybe GDP wise or the economic conditions wise, they're very high? Because they basically, what they did is they relied on the technology. They started a Singapore university and they given a whatever is the benefits required for the PhD scholars or the doctorates from all over the world, and invited them and to develop the new technologies, and they sold all the technologies or took the patents. Of course, India is very ancient, we have a lot of history and a lot of technology, but never been passed to the generations. It has been with the whoever is the old saints and all, and never been documented maybe, and never been patented. That's our unfortunate as of being Indian. But the reason here is, you know, the recently science congress, isn't it? It's happened in the Tirupati. It's all encouraged by the government. You know, the technology is the key for our success, and we have a very high target where we are going to the other countries, and we are proving, and other countries are encouraging us to develop and patent. And even like, you know, Cisco or Intel, we have so many of our Indians are working in Microsoft and Apple and all because of our talent going abroad and all. But the Modi government is taking care of that and is encouraging research and then getting the patents and all. Not only that, you have to understand is, once you started some research, don't stop it. Continue and at least pass on to the next generation, ask them to continue. It should come into the one industry. Lot of times, 98% of your research is stopped as a documentation, never been turned into the industry. It need to be done. For that, one thing is of course the government. Next thing is, you should present your whatever that you are doing to the hedge fund managers or the businessmen like us. We are eagerly waiting to invest the money, but we don't get any good proposals or projects. Otherwise, there are a lot of people, even in Vijayawada itself, tons of people are there ready to invest into the technological world. But you know, when you present it, a small things what you do and need to be completely done and a presentable form, then it can be taken to the product level. So I request those who completed the PhD and those who are going to get the PhD, don't stop where you are. It's a PhD, it's just a starting point to continue the research, or an eligible point for you to get a grant or whatever it is to do your research. So I wish you all the best, and you know, those who are delegates here presenting, and I wish you all the good luck in your success in your future. God bless you. Thank you.
Valuable message, and actually everybody has to concur with Lata Sopara Garu, because Modi's government's startup is really creating wonders across India, and with this inspiration our students and faculty also have to be motivated, have to get inspired by all these words, and they have to materialize, especially doctorates and all the talent and intelligence, they have to materialize all that. Then only they will be successful in career. So with this, before I welcome our chief guest to speak, let me introduce him to the audience, please. Dr. K. Raghunath Garu. He did his Bachelor of Technology in the stream of Electronics and Communication Engineering from from Nagarjuna University, Andhra Pradesh. Later, he did his M.E. in Electronics and Communication Engineering from Trichy, Tamil Nadu. After that, he did his doctorate from Sri Venkatesa University, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh. Coming to his experience, as a scientific officer, he worked for Applied Microwave Electronics Engineering and Research, SAMEER, Samir, Department of Electronics, Government of India, during 1991 to 1997 at various levels in Microwave Power Engineering Division. He also worked for MST Radar Transmitter, Antenna Integration, Testing and Commissioning, RF Drivers, Sonar Duplexer Unit, etc. As an engineer, he worked for National Atmospheric Research Laboratory, Department of Science, Government of India. He has been since 1997 at various levels. He has been working in the field of radars and lidars, and presently scientist, SF and head, atmospheric structure and dynamics group. Coming to his area of interest in research, that is communication systems with specific interest towards atmospheric instrumentation and research. He has handled a lot many major projects, and to mention a few here, MST radar, Doppler lidar and DIAL lidar in progress. He is a member of so many professional bodies. Let me mention a few here. Senior member in IEEE, fellow in IETE, fellow in OSI, Optical Society of India, member in